The Fed is barely able to keep up the facade any longer. Markets are always in a state of worry. Will the Fed take care of this or that? Will the Fed tuck me in at night? This is the ridiculous level we have stooped to at this point, where we see that 10 years of central bank intervention has only exacerbated the worst crisis in a century to unfold what is on pace to become worse than 2008. Hang on tight, it's going to be a wild one. You came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. Today I have an absolutely jam-packed episode. I'm going to give you a quick update on what's happening with the Fed's repos. We are going to look at what's going on in Europe, all country world index. I'm going to cover several factors to do with the economy, the PMIs. And then at the end, we're going to get into the Thomas Cook bankruptcy, which has been in the news right now. Many people have asked about what's happening. Let's get into it right away. Just to give you a quick update on what's happening with the Fed repos, I had been touching on this in several videos recently. Just wanted to show you the fact that it is only $65.75 billion as opposed to the $75 billion that we have been seeing. So the maximum being $75 billion, and it was right up to the very top and even oversubscribed. However, on Monday, it was actually only, that is, in quotations, of course, 65 billion. So we're going to see what happens on the next day, and I will track this and keep you updated as all the details that I like to just constantly keep an eye on. Wanted to give you that. We'll move on. Now, this right here is out of Fortune, and if you want to read a really good article, very detailed, this one here is what you should take a look at. The link will be in the description as always. Just wanted to touch on a couple points from here. Even though the Fed has routinely used open market operations in the past to stabilize these funding markets, it doesn't look like a few routine interventions will be sufficient. Moreover, it's becoming clear that banks need more reserves on hand. On Friday, the Fed pledged to allow roughly two more weeks of overnight repo transactions, each injecting around $75 billion daily into the economy. I brought you that data already, but take a look at this. This is a quote directly from Bank of America. For all intents and purposes, this will be equivalent to QE with scheduled purchases of securities. We estimate that over the first year, the Fed would need to buy roughly $400 billion of Treasury securities to achieve an appropriate level of reserves plus a buffer. I wanted you to hear that directly from Bank of America, not from me. So that's the information that you need to know right now. I will move on because I have been talking about this a lot. Just wanted to show you this article from CNBC that is interconnected with this issue, but then gets into the LIBOR. Now, you might know the LIBOR. Although it is spelled L-I-B-O-R, I always like to spell it the proper way, and that is LIBOR. Because if you remember, as it discusses right here in this article, back in 2012, they had a little scandal. That's right. And in fact, they were manipulating the derivatives, and in fact did so not just one instance that occurred by some rogue trader. No. This was systemic. All of the banks were in on it. And of course, we see the problems that persist in other commodities trading and others, where you see people getting a little slap on the wrist, or maybe they burn one or two people. It's going on everywhere in all of these markets. What's interesting about this is that they started talking about the replacement to LIBOR, and that is the Secured Overnight Financing Rate. But this is a big problem. Look at the repo situation. Clearly, the markets need more stability. They need something that is there with a firm footing, a solid foundation, and in the next couple years, they are not going to be able to transfer over to this new system. We're talking about $200 trillion worth that use the LIBOR today. It has its own problems, I understand, but going to this new system when there is clearly something fundamentally wrong is going to mean disaster. Perhaps this won't occur in the way that they say it will. I'll keep you up to date on this as well. I just want to show you this on a map. It's actually interesting to see it when you look at the geography. Central banks right now are clearly going in one direction. There is just one country that is colored in, and you could see the increase being only from one part. Whereas you look around the rest of the world, they are either holding interest rates or reducing them. And that is definitely the general trend that brings us into the negative rates that we've seen so many times, being hailed as a good thing, as the savior. But in fact, we've had nothing but problems. Look at the MSCI All World Index, and you notice something. It is very clear that the market throughout 2019 has been extremely fragile. They keep blaming Brexit. They keep blaming the US-China trade tensions. But fundamentally, something is going on. Take a look at this. Out of market economics, you can see the German PMI, not good at all, okay? If you look at the statistics here on the left-hand side, as well as the chart on the right-hand side, it is definitely not looking good right now. For Germany, their manufacturing PMI at 41.4, that is the sharpest decline in business conditions across the goods producing sector since the depths of the global financial crisis in mid-2009. This is supposedly the strongest country in Europe, and it is impervious to everything that's happening. It's doing so fantastically, and yet it is suffering right now. And we can see that even in these numbers here, which they can always pad, they can always make look better, but it looks to me as if the weakness is clearly present. The private sector is suffering its worst downturn in almost 7 years. This just shows you the black line, which is the manufacturing PMI. Composite PMI and services PMI also on a decline here on this chart. Now, I wanted to show you what's happening in the US. This has actually turned up slightly in the last little while. Wanted to make that very clear that at least in the short term, things look a little bit better when it comes to the PMIs for the United States. However, if you see the general trend, just like what we've seen in basically every other country from 2018 and on, the trend has been down. This just shows you on the chart, this turnaround that we're seeing right now could be an indication of better things to come, or simply could be another blip that we have seen in other instances along the way on this path downward. That happens to be what's occurring in the United States, but of course we see that other places too. Now check out the dark red line. As you can see, the Eurozone manufacturing PMI has been sinking in a straight line since the beginning of 2018. We also see on here Japan's and China's and the United States. Like I said, they generally seem to be declining right now. I wanted to give you an update on this as well. This is the negative yielding debt globally, and it is at $14.5 trillion. It peaked out just under $17 trillion and had come down significantly, and looks like it's going to be headed back up to a record high. I'll keep you up to date on that. This is important here. You can see the South Korean exports year over year declining at a rate which hasn't been seen since the financial crisis. I showed you this many times, and I specifically said, if it's a trend, then we have something to worry about. And right now it is very clear that this is a trend. They are actually reporting their numbers before other countries, so it gives you an indication of what is to come. They are also a country that is a major exporter of so many different products, so it is a bellwether of the global economy. And just look at that red line, that's South Korea's exports coming down significantly from 2017 into 2019. Doesn't look good. Okay, so really quickly, I wanted to touch on this issue with Thomas Cook bankruptcy. Family stranded, honeymoons and vacations canceled, thousands of workers laid off, the sudden collapse of British tour company Thomas Cook and its network of airlines and hotels sowed chaos for hundreds of thousands of travelers and businesses around the world. Most people had no idea this was coming, and yet 600,000 people were traveling with Thomas Cook as of Sunday, and their lives are disrupted as a result. I found a little piece of information I think you should be aware of that I hadn't seen in most mainstream media outlets, and it's this. Greed of the Thomas Cook fat cats. How high-flying bosses creamed off $47 million in pay and perks in the years before travel firm collapsed. So the top dogs made sure to get their bonuses, and yet they didn't even have enough money to make sure everybody could get back to their home country. And as far as I'm concerned, that is terrible. The way that the company just stops operating just like that, instead of canceling everybody's vacation, you bring everyone back home and say, that's it. We're not going to offer any more services. That's a whole different story. That's something you could handle later. But to simply leave everybody stranded like that, especially when we hear news like this, it's crazy. All right, that's all for this video. If you found it informative, hit that thumbs up button. Hit the like button to support this channel. It's just one click. I really do appreciate it. If you want to build a business, if you want to make money, if you want to learn about passive income, the Amazon GPS is for you. I created this free course to teach people how to make money online. Definitely check it out at theamazongps.com. If you want the financial education you are not taught in school, these two books have everything you need from top to bottom, A to Z. I get into all the details about central banks and interest rates, history of the monetary system, how to make money, everything you need to know. Check out the link in the description if you want the audiobook. That's available at themoneygps.com. Hang on a second, hold on, don't go anywhere. If you haven't seen this video, then definitely watch it. If you click on it, I will see you there.